my deepest condolences to Peter McKinnon, because 120 FPS slow motion is finally dead. Okay, look, I have nothing against Peter or 120 FPS, not at all, of course not. I also use 60 and 120 FPS for B-rolls and commercials, but fact is that it became slightly overused here on YouTube, and that's an understatement. Peter McKinnon started it, he mastered it, and then he showed everybody how cool it looks, because it does look really cool, but then eventually everybody started using it all the time, and it was just too much. But now I see videos, cinematic videos, without slow motion getting more and more popular, and I really like it. It seems like we're going back to the basics, the essence of filmmaking. Less super slow-mo shots, less crazy whip transitions. It seems like that let's shoot everything in 120 FPS slow motion hype is finally dead, or at least dying. And that's a good thing, because shooting in 60 or 120 FPS causes a few problems. First of all, and this is just my personal opinion, I feel like if you slow down a scene, 60, 120 FPS, then you lose the real, raw emotion of that scene. No matter what you're shooting, if you shoot something in slow motion, then it all feels the same. It feels like slow motion. A fast car, someone walking in the forest, a jumping dog. In slow motion, to me, it all feels the same. It feels dramatic. Overly dramatic sometimes. And that's also because you lose the sound, of course. All those scenes that I mentioned, those different scenes, if you'd watch them in real time, they'd all feel very different because of the sound. So if you shoot all your B-roll in 120 FPS slow motion, unless it's your trademark, of course, because when I watch a Peter McKinnon video, then I expect juicy 120 FPS slow motion, but you know, if you're not Peter McKinnon, then if you start shooting everything in 120 FPS, then all your videos just feel the same. I don't want 120 FPS slow motion in every video that I watch here on YouTube. That's just too much. So I'd say try shooting 120 FPS slow motion or 60 FPS slow motion sporadically, only when it adds value to a scene or a video. Another example is those cinematic travel films that are shot entirely in slow motion. When I watch one of those, I don't feel the vibe and the atmosphere of a country. It all feels like slow motion, overly dramatic, and fake even. You know what I mean? It's all the same. It's like they're thinking, oh, how am I gonna make this look cinematic? Oh, I know, just shoot it in slow motion. But that's not how it works. You know what? I would highly recommend you to check out Danny Gewerts, I don't know how to pronounce it. I call him Danny G. So check out Danny G's work. He makes great videos without slow motion. Danny G sounds really cool, by the way. Or like a pimp. I don't know. Whatever. I'm sorry, Danny. I just really like your work. But again, guys, this is a very, very subjective discussion. If you like to shoot everything in 120 FPS and you like it, no problem, that's fine. I'm not gonna stop you. I also think it looks really, really cool, but not for everything. That's where I'm different then. I like the raw, real emotion of real time. I don't know, and I also think that, of course, the hype is dying or died because pretty much every camera now, every new camera, shoots 120 FPS. It's not new anymore. Not new and exciting. Okay, and then, well, then there's the problem of what frame rate should I shoot in then? If I want to mix real time and slow motion footage. Well, yeah, that's a bit of a problem. And this video is shot in 30 frames per second, by the way, so I can show you some examples. Again, it's all personal preference, but I'd say shoot all real-time footage in the frame rate of your project, so 24, 25, or 30. I never use 60 FPS for real-time footage because I just don't like the look. But again, personal preference. And then switch to 60 or 120 FPS when you know that you'll slow down the footage. So yeah, you have to know before you start shooting which footage, which scenes you'll slow down. And that's a bit of planning required. Now, look, I know that some of you shoot everything in 60fps so that you can decide later when you're editing if you're gonna slow down the footage or not. You always have both options if you're editing on a 30p timeline, for example. The editor will just drop half of the frames if you don't slow down the footage and it'll look okay. But, and this is the problem, but it won't look the same as true real 30p footage with a shutter speed of 1/60th. Because of the shutter speed. Because the shutter speed decides the amount of motion blur. And when shooting in 30fps, your shutter speed for the most natural looking motion blur should be 1/60th. Of course, again, it's subjective, but in general, most filmmakers agree to the 180 degree rule. So 30fps, shutter speed 1/60th, or shutter speed double the frame rate. But that means that when you decide to shoot in 60fps, you should use a shutter of 1/120th or 1/125th on most mirrorless cameras. So a faster shutter speed, and that means that there will be less motion blur. So if you drop that footage on a 30p timeline, it'll look different because your shots won't have the same motion blur. It won't look like true 30fps with a shutter of 1/60th. It'll look fine, it'll look okay, but not the same. That's what I'm trying to say here, because wow. Anyway, the difference between these two is not super significant, but there is a difference. Depends on how fast an object is moving, and if you shoot 120fps, then the difference will be more significant. But you know, it's something that you have to know, regardless of if you like it or not. Now, you could say, why not shoot everything in 60fps with a shutter of 1/60th? Because then, when you drop that footage on a 30p timeline, it'll have the same amount of motion blur and it'll look the same. Yes, that's true. But then you'll have a problem if you want to slow down the footage, because then your footage will have too much motion blur. Because, you know, usually, if you slow down footage, it shouldn't have too much motion blur, because a slow-moving object doesn't have much motion blur. It doesn't feel natural if it has too much motion blur. But again, this is totally subjective. Some people like that look. 60 frames per second, shutter of 1/60th, and then slow down. And that's why there is that 180 degree rule, or shutter double the frame rates. It's to make it easier and less complicated, so that you always have the best looking result. But it's just a guideline, it's not a rule. And again, there's no right or wrong. But you should definitely know that if you want to mix real-time footage and slow motion, that shooting everything in a higher frame rate, 60fps, is not the magical solution, because it will have consequences. I still think that the best way is to only shoot in higher frame rates if you're gonna slow down the footage. But of course, that requires planning. And if you want to shoot everything in 60fps so that you have the option to slow it down or not, great! I mean, it doesn't look bad. Just know that it has consequences and that it will look different. And if you're shooting videos for yourself, it's not a problem at all. But if you shoot an assignment, for example, and they specifically ask 30 frames per second, well, then you have to know that if you're gonna shoot everything in 60fps and drop that on a 30 timeline, you have to know about those consequences. Or you have to ask them specifically, is it okay if I shoot everything in 60fps and then drop it on a 30p timeline? You know? Yeah. Wow, my brain is fried. Really. I hope it helps. I hope you understand now the consequences and, you know, how subjective all of this is. You know what? I'll link a few of Gerald Undone's videos in the description, and he shows you exactly what the differences are. Different frame rates, different shutter speeds, what the consequences are, and what works and what doesn't work. Side by side. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and see you in the next one. Boom!